Hi everyone and welcome back. And after a long time, I'm going to put more videos in this playlist where I'm talking about JavaScript interview questions which can be related to React, Angular, Node.js or vanilla JavaScript. Okay, so this playlist will be covers everything. And first of all, I think everybody is doing good in this pandemic situation. Okay, and I hope everybody is safe. Okay, coming to the point, now we are going to cover JavaScript interview questions, which will talk about ESX features, what are object-oriented programming features in JavaScript, how to have all these, what are the prototype, what is the proto, how we do the inheritance, what is the this keyword, then some latest features of ESX, then we will talk about execution context, event loop, event queue, and all these things. So in the first video, let's talk about arrow function. So arrow function is the first topic which we pick, and this is popular also, and people often get confused with arrow functions and simple functions. They know when to use arrow functions, how it works, what all advantage it is providing us while using the arrow function. Okay, now if you look at this example, what it is doing is we have a user object and we are calling this one method, meth1 and meth2. Okay, these are two methods we have. Okay, this is an arrow function, and how we write arrow function is simply like if you say hi, earlier we were writing something like this. Now const say hi, if I replace it with this, then it is something like this, right? In arrow functions, you don't need to use a function keyword in, you can directly define the, if it is having some argument, then you don't need to even specify the bracket. This is an arrow function, right? But what arrow function is giving? Arrow function is providing you the lexical this binding, right? So what arrow function is giving you when you are using arrow function, it is able to access the scope whatever is available here. Okay, immediate outer scope it is able to access. Currently, if you just use function keyword here, this is a simple code, right? What we are doing here is we have this simple function and we can easily access this dot name because we are in the same context. User.math1 will give us the name which is ZFZ, right? But when you introduce an arrow function here, what additional thing we started doing is, now whatever the scope we are accessing here, now it can also access the global scope, right? In the current scope, we have a name property and all, but with the help of arrow function now, this starts pointing to a window object. If you just try to do console.log this, and what you will get, you are going to get window object here and name property is not there. But in another case, console.log this.name, here it has name property which is GFZ. So this inside an arrow function always inherit that this from the enclosing scope, right? This is the feature of arrow function, but you can still bind all the other parameters of an arrow function. That means what it is doing is it is inheriting the scope, inheriting the outer scope from the enclosing, right? So currently this scope is bind to this context, right? But with the arrow function, now you are still able to access the outer scope, which is a window object. Okay, now let's try to differentiate what is the arrow functions and how it is different from our general functions, right? A simple functions, like if I talk about const x and I created a function here, this is anonymous function, right? But still I can create an object of this function using new keyword. Can I do this with arrow function? No, because arrow function doesn't have its own context. It is actually pointing to the outer enclosing context, right? So if you try to do the same trick for the arrow function, then you will get an error. This is an arrow function I created and I'm trying to call it using new keyword, new and constructor. It will not work, right? Regular functions created using function declaration or expressions are constructible and callable. Since further functions are constructible, they can be called using the new keyword, which we are doing, new x. However, the arrow functions are only callable and not constructible. This means we can actually call them. You can actually call it using something like this, but you can't construct using new keyword. You should always remember this, okay? Now let's try to see the difference. Let's try to talk about simple examples to understand more about it. So this is our example, this user, and we have a show method in this, and we are talking about argument. So obviously arguments is always an object in JavaScript which represents what you are passing in the object. So if you try to change it to an arrow function, let's try to see this, and we will try to identify why that is happening, right? It is going to print a strange output, and why? That can be the good question, right? Arguments, here we are passing arguments, and arguments should print the same thing, whatever the argument we are passing, but it is going to print a weird output, maybe undefined or something, because in this arrow function, this function is not bound to the current context. Now it is bound to the outer enclosing context, and there we don't have arguments, right? So either it will print undefined and so, or some vague response we are going to get. Okay, now when to use arrow function, when not to use arrow function, that is again a good question. So sometimes what happens, you see nested functions when you need to access this object. Like many examples, if we talk about React framework, there we do explicit binding for the DOM events and all, there we need arrow function. But where we don't need arrow function, let's take a look on some examples. Okay, here what we are doing, we are creating a link and we are trying to click on to this link. This example will give us more clarity when to use or when not to use. Okay, document.getElementById, I added a mouse enter event, okay, and I'm trying to access this context here. This works fine. Here this will point to the DOM event where you have clicked on it. Now if you just change it to an arrow function, let's do something like this. This is how we can convert this to arrow function. So if we introduce the arrow function, now this context currently pointing to the DOM event, now this will point to the window object, and there is no class list object, right? So when using an arrow function, this is not bound to anything, and it just inherit from the parent scope, which may be a window object. If we use a regular function, then this will bound to the element we clicked, but here this element, this will start pointing to the window object, and we lost the context here, okay, and it will create a problem, right? Now another example on the same line, this is where you should avoid using it. Here also, this is another example. Here you can use simple function, but we thought of using arrow function, and we have already talked about it. Here this will point to the window object, and it will not increase the points value. Okay, so the output will always be a 23 in this particular case, right? Now so these are just a simple examples. Okay, if you wanted to fix it, what you can do is you can actually use a function keyword, and now this will bind to the person object. It will keep increasing point to 23, to 24, to 25. Okay, these are some quick examples what is arrow function and how it works. Okay, thanks everyone.